Is true love actually real? Do you think true love is real, or is it something else? Perhaps it is a social construct. Maybe it's our mind playing a sick trick on us. Does everybody have a true love out there in the world? Maybe even more than one? If you believe you found true love, I'd be honored to hear your definition of it and why you believe your love is, in fact, true love.
Hi, I am Stacy. As the question is, do you think true love is real, or is it something else? So by discussing, a guy said this, love is a chemical reaction in the body. True love is after that wears off, which sometimes takes years, and you realize that the person is actually your best friend and who you want to share your life with. Whether that's one person or, like me, two people, where, me and my wife, partner, and we have been together 15 plus years. There's no butterflies in the stomach this many years down the road, but they are my very best friends and I want them with me for what time I have left. All that, true love, and one and only, is nothing but romanticized horseshit. There's almost 8 billion people on the planet and there is definitely more than one person that anyone would be happy with. They just happen to stop looking at the point that someone gave them butterflies. That giddy, love, feeling is nothing but dopamine, serotonin and oxytocin. Maybe a bit of adrenaline thrown in for good measure.
Hi. It's me, Justin. I asked one of my friend about true love. My friend told about his wonderful lovely wife. He said, I believe what my wife and I have for each other is true love. From the very first interaction we had, she had my attention. I could listen to what she had to say for hours. She listens to what I have to say and asks questions and repeats back to me later on so that we are communicating. We're on the same page with everything. It feels weird if I experience something without her. If I enjoy something, I want her to experience it too so I can see her have a good time. She actively gives me permission to have alone time to rest. She is always looking for an opportunity to share my hobbies because she wants to be with me through the things I enjoy. I always ask her about the books she's reading. I don't read, but she does, and that's what I care about. I'm always asking what she needs, food, rest, a task, anything. It's hers and I know she'd do the same when I ask because I do and she does. No questions, no excuses, she just does it for me and I always thank her and she always welcomes me. I respect her space and get desires and she respects mine. I'm always looking for new things to do with her. It doesn't matter if it's a walk around the block or a drive across the country, as long as we can talk to each other. I need to know how she feels. I'm always making plans and goals for the future, running scenarios, and she's always budgeting to make it happen. I don't make a decision without her input, and if I do, it's because I have to and I'm considering her needs above all things and apologize when I tried and it didn't work out. She always forgives me. We have two kids now. It's never an easy day, but we still have twinkles in our eyes when we see each other. I thought about if another woman could take her place and there's no possible way, even if I tried my hardest to make it happen. We are one and the same and I want no one else but her for as long as I live. To anyone else, I would be a good husband and to anyone else she would be a good wife, but we fit each other.
Hi, I am Doris. There are human waves like light waves or sea waves. If you've ever worked in a grocery, you've seen these peaks and troughs of human movements. True love occurs when two people are closely aligned, traveling together within a discrete wavelength. Love and attraction have dozens of components, but the point is the alignment. We fall into sync. When that occurs, the feelings of love and attraction redouble. The connectivity we feel is profound, bordering on the spiritual. This is where two people seemingly become one. Thoughts, intentions, dispositions become uniquely unified. People can sync up in these intense ways and they can fall out of sync. I have had many loves but only a few true loves which fit this description. People mistakenly think love is some static form of being. It's always in flux, and the sign of true love is when two people's fluctuations are mirrored in each other. Part of it is kismet, the unknowable fate of the universe. And part of it is intentional, the sensitivity and desire to remain in sync. People will fall in and out of love. True love endures the tests of time. But even it suffers from attenuation, if the human forces aren't maintaining their roles. When that happens, it's time to hop onto another wavelength and find out what will happen.
Hello. It's me, Kevin. I believe in true love, love at first sight because I believe that I experienced it. I think I loved my former partner from the moment I met them. Everything felt so different and it was awesome while it lasted. The relationship ended over unfortunate circumstance, but I feel in my bones that that was true love and I'll be looking for it again for forever. Yes. I would add that it is also something that takes continuous work and commitment. You can find true love, someone that you feel a great connection with, but if you don't nurture it, that love will fade or worse still, those strong emotions will turn to hate and anger. True love is caring, being considerate, going out of your way to make the other person's day better.
Hello. I am Ivy. I'm certain that it's real. Just look at any old couple who are treating each other with the same affection after 30 years as at THR beginning of their relation. We should be aware of each other's flaws and we've navigated them gracefully with patience and forgiveness because, first of all, none of them are serious, and secondly what others find annoying with us we shrug and move on. We have to match each other, nearly one and the same.